Good morning, kids, and welcome to E5's Church online lesson. Today we're going to start by looking at last week's craft. Do you remember it? The stones will cry out. Well, thank you, Michelle and Michael, for sending in your picture. You look like you're having fun in the sun. Good job, Amani, for your picture. You've made them look so colourful. And Joel, you sent in this picture and your stones are rocking out in praise. Anastasia, your stones look fabulous. They're even giving us a wave. Brilliant work, Stephen. Your stone faces look super cool. Abigail, you've worked really hard on the statements. Your stones are crying out and I love it. Now, I'm sure you've had a week filled with schoolwork, helping out at home and playing. Well, let's just start today with a song of praise, because we all know with Jesus, nothing is impossible.
Obviously, this is just to let you know that the Zoom Bible study will be happening again this week from anyone aged 7 to 10 on Wednesday at 4 o'clock. This week was amazing for us to all get together and see you all, which was great, and we can just study the Word together. And I cannot wait to see more and more of you this week. See you then.
What will we arrest him for?
We'll find something.
I heard him say he was going to kill the Emperor.
He uses dark magic to win over simpletons.
He said he would tear down God's temple
and build it again in 3 days.
Don't you have an answer to what these men are testifying against you? Tell us, are you the Messiah, the Son of God?
Yes, I am. Soon you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right side of God, all-powerful, and coming on the clouds of heaven.
This man claims to be God. We don't need any more witnesses. You've heard what he said. What do you think?
He is guilty and deserves to die.
It can't be. It can't be!
You're a friend of his, aren't you? You were with him.
I don't know what you mean.
But you were. This man was with Jesus.
I don't even know the man.
You are one of them. You can tell by your accent.
I'm not lying. I don't know him.
My God, why have you deserted me?
We went to his tomb, but he wasn't there. The angel said he was alive, that he has risen. He told us to tell you. He told us to meet him near where it all started.
Don't be afraid.
I didn't come to invite good people to be my followers. I came to invite sinners. You are all welcome.
Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord!
Ascend to the Son of David!
Follow me, and from now on you will bring in people instead of fish.
I love Jesus because he died on the cross for me.
Good morning and welcome to this week's craft. I hope you're having lots of fun at home. This week's craft, you just need lots of different coloured pieces of paper, a pair of scissors, some glue and a pen. And I give you 1 minute to go and grab those items. angle, but hopefully you can see what we're doing now. So I'm hoping you have some piece of paper, okay? And then with one of your coloured pieces of paper, you are going to cut it into a hand shape. So draw around your hand and cut it out. You might need some adults to help you cut that out. And once you've got that handprint, it can just go like this on your big piece of paper. Okay? So once you've done that, also we can get some glue and stick the hand down. Paper. Okay, so hopefully you should have that now. Next bit, you are going to make it look a bit like a plant pot. So cut out a bit like a plant pot. If you haven't got different colours, maybe you can use plain paper and make a funky colour pattern plant pot. And you're going to stick that at the bottom. Already some different flower petals going on, lots of different colors. Okay, so you need 5 of these, so 1 flower petal for each finger of your hand. And once you've done those, we're just going to spread them out on the top of our fingertips. Out, we can stick those on. And on each petal, each flower, you're going to spell out Jesus. So you're going to do J. You're going to put is alive. Hope you've done that. Okay, so from this verse that we are reading, it is from 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 3. And it says, "Praise be to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead." So you can either choose to write that verse down on your plant pot, or you can just write the Bible verse down to remind you what verse we were doing. So I'm just going to write the Bible verse down. So it is 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 3. Just kind of like that. So hopefully your craft should look like this. I can't wait to see all your very pretty plants and flowers. I can imagine there being lots of colour on them. And that is our craft done for the week. I hope you have a great week. I can't wait to see all your creations. See you soon.
Hello everyone, my name is Michelle and I'm going to be playing Jesus Loves Me.
Now, I hope you've got your Bibles ready with a piece of paper and a pen, as Haniel is going to read from us our Bible passage, and I'm going to ask you some questions afterwards. So please open up your Bibles to Luke chapter 18, and we're going to read verse 9 to 14.
Chapter 18, verse 9 to 14, the parable of the Pharisee and the tax collector. To some who were confident of their own righteousness and looked down on everyone else, Jesus told this parable. Two men went up to the temple to pray, one a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood by himself and prayed, God, I thank you that I am not like other people, robbers, evildoers, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week and give a tenth of all I get. But the tax collector stood at a distance. He would not even look up to heaven, but beat his breast and said, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. I tell you that this man, rather than the other, went home justified before God. For all those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted.
Okay, so now we've got some questions. So the first one, what do you think was wrong with the prayer that the Pharisee prayed? Was he really praying to God? And why was he saying that prayer? Why was God pleased with the prayer of the tax collector? Now, how were the two prayers different? Now, the tax collector wanted to be made right with God, whereas the Pharisee was looking for an opportunity to brag and to tell everyone what a great guy he was. Now, even though this story was told over 2,000 years ago, it still applies to us today. So why don't you take a bit of time to spend with your adult, or maybe your brother, your sister, and just spend time praying, but an honest prayer. What are the things that are on your heart that you just want to be honest with God about? Why don't you take time praying with your adult now?
Hello, E5 kids. Missing you guys so much, and I hope you're all well at home, staying, having fun at home as well. Jesus taught all his followers how to pray, and he gives us an outline of what prayer should look like. Our Father who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. And this is recognizing who God is and praising him for it. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And this means that God is interested in the things that happen on earth, and he wants his will to be done. Give us this day our daily bread. And here we're just asking God for our daily needs, like food. Forgive us of our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And this means that we're asking God to help us spiritually and emotionally so that we can stay close to him. Yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. And this last bit is praising God for who he is and what he does. So we praise and worship God. Also add our own specific prayers to the prayer that Jesus gave us, and they could be specific to us.
My soul.